Hey guys, what's up? It's Sean, Autotopia LA. And if you saw the last episode, you saw me with a gigantic smile on my face as I drove around in this beautiful Superformance GT40 Mark I. But what are we getting into today? Well, Superformance was cool enough to bring up not just one, but two GT40s. This one they call the Future 40, and there's a lot of reasons for that. There's elements you're gonna see obviously that are not of the old Mark 1, 2, 4 GT40, but then there's a lot of elements of it that are. This is a combination, obviously wearing the modern livery of the 2016 Le Mans winning GT40. We're gonna get into it as much as we did the last one. As excited as I was to drive that car, I cannot wait to get in and drive this car. So Doug from Superformance is here again. We're gonna go hit the canyon, talk some details, and have a blast. So hold on, because here we go, man. All right, you guys, we're back with Doug from Superformance.
So good to be back.
Right? It's been a while.
I could come here every day. I really could.
So this, you guys call the Future 40.
Future GT40, yeah, this is near and dear to my heart.
Yeah, I know it is. Yeah. I've seen yours, which this one's not Doug's. Doug has a whole different version of this car.
But, yeah.
So this is kind of a combo of the historic and then the modern.
Right. This was an idea I had while watching Le Mans back in 2017.
Yeah.
Because I was working to plan my own personal GT40, and I saw the four GTs run around the track in the red, white, and blue livery, and just said, that's it.
It's such a killer livery. It's so great.
And then do the aero and do the wheels and, you know, and it just mushroomed from there and became a thing that, you know, I launched my car at SEMA last year.
So you were the creator of this design?
Yeah, I came up with the idea to do it, and then Lance, the owner of Superformance, liked it so much, he ordered this one for himself.
Oh, so this is Lance's
car. This is Lance's car, yeah.
This is the owner of the company's car.
So we can beat the crap out of this one.
So now this one, the body is still GT40.
Same as the one you drove before. It's a Mark 1 GT40.
Okay.
But the livery really throws people off.
But there's more than the livery. Like there's the lights, the canards, the aero, the wing.
It's like all my favorite stuff from the original GT40 blended with the new 4 GT Le Mans car. That's really what it is. And it's my favorite mashup of the two cars.
Right. Now, and yours is the six cylinder.
Yeah, I've got the twin turbo.
You got the twin turbo EcoBoost motor. This one does not.
No, this one, Lance wanted a as he would say in his South African accent, a proper V8.
Got it.
Yeah.
Got it.
So he has but still a modern engine. So this is a supercharged Coyote.
Okay.
It's a 5-liter Coyote with our Roush supercharger on it.
Oh, God.
Yeah. And it can easily be tuned to make north of 800.
Got it. Yeah. Wow.
And the car still weighs about 2,450, 2,500 pounds.
Wow. Talk about power to weight, you guys. Yeah.
My car has full RideTech Shockwave air suspension, so the whole car lifts up and down.
Okay.
This car still has the standard shocks, but it has a hydraulic front end lift so that the front splitter clears, because we don't want to mess up that pretty carbon fiber splitter down there.
No.
We want the car to be a functional street car, which this one is. I mean, you talk about freeway cruising in this car.
Yeah.
It's such a pleasant experience with the modern engine in particular. And then, you know, you set it for a great road ride height, but then you can lift the front end another 3 inches to clear the nastiest of parking lots. So you can be comfortable driving this pretty much anywhere.
Okay. And how about brakes? Is it still, do you guys still use Wilwood here as well?
Still Wilwood, but a little different story here. We've got 14-inch rotors with 6-piston calipers on all four wheels.
Oh, God.
And then modern HRE wheels, 18 front, 19 back, instead of the 15-inch BRM wheels. And these replicate very nicely the 4 GT race wheels.
Got
still center lock, but now with the nut instead of the spinner.
Yeah.
So again, the more modern look.
Yeah. Okay. Then what about exhaust? Is this completely different exhaust setup than again versus the old one?
Completely different. So the old one has the what they call the bundle of snakes exhaust, which is famous for the GT40s.
Yeah.
This car actually has a custom exhaust done by the guys who did the drivetrain installation, V's Performance in Orange, California.
Okay.
And they did a custom fabricated stainless exhaust system. They still did the 180 crossover, which is famous from the bundle of snakes,
right,
but they actually did it in firing order. So it produces with the Coyote a very unique sound and looks really, really cool.
Yeah. I heard the sound when you guys were pulling it off the trailer. I mean, these two cars sound Like just completely different universes. I mean, really far out. Now this one I also noticed, which I'm really excited to drive, is that it's right-hand drive, but it's got the shifter on the sill.
Yeah.
Now, is it still the same tank setup? Is there still tanks on both sides?
Yeah, still the two 10.5 gallon tanks on the sills. Exact same, the chassis, body, everything's exactly the same.
Okay.
Yeah.
It really does make you, you know, wonder, like, what's going on here? Because it, you can tell it's based on the old body, you know? I mean, but it's, but it looks, not just from the livery, but adding all the aero stuff, it just, it looks dramatically different. It really does.
And what's cool is it's all functional. I mean, you can do stuff that's just for looks.
Yeah.
But this like kills two birds with one stone. You get killer looks, you get something that really pays homage to both cars, but it's all functional stuff. And I've had my car on the track and I know that splitter and those front canards work because, man, the front end's so well planted going through the banking at Auto Club Speedway turns one and two.
Yeah.
You can really feel it working.
Yeah. And I notice here, I mean, obviously this is a fully adjustable wing, so you can go almost no downforce or radical downforce.
Exactly. The modern engine, whether it's the twin turbo EcoBoost or the supercharged Coyote, makes the car feel completely different.
Yeah.
Completely different. Totally changes the personality of the car. So I'm really curious to see what you think.
Well, we just got to go for a drive now. That's what we got to do.
Please?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Guys, here we are driving the future GT40. We've already gotten it up here, so I've been driving it for a few minutes. Noticeably different car. I mean, there's elements already that feel exactly like the other car, other than that I'm definitely sitting on the wrong side or the right side.
I think the right side, yeah. For a GT40, I think the right side is the right side.
I mean, I love having right away the shifter being here, just like this is what it felt like for those guys when they were racing. You know, I mean, the manual steering, the manual brakes, that's all reminiscent of what the other car is. Although the big difference right away is the engine is so noticeably different. What'd you say the power is on this one?
650.
Yeah.
It's very mild, so it could easily be tweaked up to 800, north 800 horsepower.
But I mean, in comparison to driving the other one, which was 450, so I mean, that 200 horsepower right away is just so noticeable. So this is still, though, in that 2400-ish range?
Well, you're about 2,450, 2,500 pounds.
Just so light compared to where we're at with modern cars now, you know?
Yeah.
I'd say it's about as loud in the cockpit as the other car is.
But it's a different
sound.
It's
a different loud.
Yeah.
But it's loud in here as well. It's not...
What?
Exactly. I gotta admit, right away, dude, I like the extra power, just knowing that it's there.
Coyote's really just such a great power plant.
It sure is.
I call it the LS of the Ford world.
Yeah, well, it is.
It's
such a go-to motor. You can bank on it being a great motor. You know... And it's reliable, it makes great power. If you want to make massive power, it's not hard to do.
Yeah, woo! Yeah, boy.
And I mean, I'm barely getting into it. I'm at $3,000, you know.
I love that sound.
Yeah, it's such a good tone. Gosh. I like them. I want one, man. I really want one of these. All right, you guys, that's it for our shoot of this wonderful future GT40. Definitely not our last shoot with the Superformance guys because I've now begged them to let us come shoot more of their cars. So you're definitely going to see more with me and the Superformance guys. They're extraordinarily cool people, and the cars they build are, I mean, I think they kind of speak for themselves. I love the raw elements of this car. There's no granny assists to protect you. If you get out of control, it's gonna let you do it. I love that it's manual steering, it's manual brakes, it's visceral, it's loud. My ears are still a little torqued right now. I'm completely and totally blown away that I've gotten to drive now two of their cars with more to come. So I hope you guys had a good time in this episode because I had a blast. As always, I say this and I mean it. Thank you for watching and supporting and hanging out with us. It really matters. I love watching the channel continue to grow. So thank you very much, and I will see you in the next episode. All right, man. Later.